dinner. I did not feel good at all today. I even got out of my freaking bra. Don't really know what to do. It's literally so hot in here. I don't really want to do anything at all today. I guess I can just talk about. I don't remember who gave them to her, but one of her friends was giving away clothes and they got there, some couple pairs of jeans and a pair of super high top Converse and combat boots. I just do not feel very well today. I guess we'll talk about awkward moments from high school. Let's see. I didn't really have any friends. I used to hang out with the weird kids, the weird goth kids, and that one kid that always wore the leather jacket. That was Curtis, by the way. I didn't really have any friends outside of them. There was a lot of shit happening to me. I mean, this one girl, her name I think was Kyla or something around there. Kayla. She like made it her life's mission to make my life miserable. And she pretty much turned the entire school against me. Spread rumors about me. It was like I was in a freaking teenage soap opera. Like Degrassi or something. Aside from feeling like crap today, my hair was on point. And it kind of should be considering I'm taking 2 showers today. So, I also had a lot of shit going on at home. And she never really, she wasn't in any clubs or anything, so I tried to stay in as many as possible that interested me. Like, I was in DECA, which was okay. And I was in the fashion club, which was purely just to be around people who didn't hate me. I was president of the Lego club, but that's only because Curtis was the previous president, and he used his senior year to focus on school and stuff. His senior year was my junior year. He is an entire year older than me, obviously. So I guess I don't know if I technically came out to the entire school. I just remember, okay, Amanda was Curtis's girlfriend. She's bisexual. And we had the same gym class. And one day after class, she asked me out. And she talked for about a week, trying to figure out how I felt. Whatever. And the only thing that made me stop, the only thing that stopped me from saying yes is the fact that she was still dating Curtis, and he actually turned out to be one of my best friends. I think I told that story before, but I haven't told the second part. After I figured out all my feelings and stuff, we were outside the hall talking, and I didn't realize that there were a couple of teenage boys at the end of the hall, because there were two, the boy and girl changing rooms are like right next to each other. And we're not really supposed to, but a lot of the kids, they hang out outside of the locker rooms after class waiting for the bell. And there was these two teenage boys by the vending machines. They had, what was it, Powerade machines outside the locker rooms. And I didn't notice them until afterwards, but I was talking to Amanda about everything. And I couldn't figure out why she was trying to shush me. It's not like I cared or anything, but. Yeah, that was awkward moment number one. Okay, this one's kind of a girl issue one. I got detention a lot in high school. Mostly because people pissed me off and I didn't care what I said. And still for today, I don't really care. I'm more sheltered than I was back then, but still. I'll pretty much say what's on my mind. I got my period in detention. And I didn't notice that until one of the boys that was in detention with me called me out on it. And I was rushed to the nurse and she gave me a hoodie. Well, it wasn't a hoodie, it was a sweater. Sweatshirt. It had the school's soccer team thing on it. Two. Oh yeah, and this was at my new school when I transferred to my senior year. See now here, homecoming is this whole thing where we dress up and everything. In Montana, they don't do that. Half the people there were just wearing jeans and t-shirts, and I didn't get dressed until I got to the dance or whatever. So I had my. It just isn't. Ow. Okay. I had my dress in my bag. And I walked to the dance and I was wearing jeans and t-shirt like everybody else. After I realized that everybody was just wearing casual clothes, I quickly changed back into my clothes I originally wore. Which actually brings me, I didn't go to my prom, but I went to my junior prom, and I wore a dress that my mom bought me the year before for a DECA thing. That I never actually got to go to. I looked pretty, I guess. I just felt really awkward though, because everybody else's dresses were so much prettier. It was masquerade night, and I was gonna make my own mask and everything. I just said, fuck it. I think I probably have the pictures somewhere. I don't know where. Probably somewhere on my Facebook or something. I didn't go to prom. I was sick. I was living with my aunt, and my cousin Crystal got sick, and I caught whatever she had. It really sucks too, but I wore my prom dress to graduation. And it wasn't extravagant or anything either. It was just this pretty peach, white, and black dress, and flowers and stuff on it. And I had these black shoes to go with it. Okay. Concert story. I went to my first actual concert was well actually no. The first concert I went to without my mom was Jonas Brothers. I was obsessed with them in high school. And I was dancing along to one of their songs at the concert and I slipped on nachos. I was with my aunt and she has never let me live it down. I was so embarrassed. Hopefully that won't happen at the Panic concert. All right, I will see you guys tomorrow. Hopefully I'll be feeling a little bit better.